I dressed my daughter for her own funeral, and it was one of the most difficult things I've ever done. Basically, at 8.5 months, my wife delivered a little girl, but that little girl was already dead. There's no signs of life at all. We immediately began to pray over her that God would give her back, and I believed wholeheartedly that He would. We had experienced that with my daughter, Kara. He had healed her, so why wouldn't He do that in this situation? My friend said to me, "What's God saying to you right now?" And I knew that God said in that moment, "Let her go." What do you mean, let go, right? I mean, how does the mind even comprehend that? This is your child, you know. I'd give my own life. I'd give everything that I have for this child to have life. I went over to Lorraine and I told her that we had to let Sherry go, and we prayed for her through the entire night and into the morning. And I broke and I said, "Fine, you can have her." And I remember the Lord spoke to me. He says, "She was always mine, and so are you." My son Ezekiel, he was with me for 16 days. The doctor said, I have no other tools to work with. I have no other options here. They took the intubation out of him. He was on a breathing machine, and I heard him cry for the first time, and for the only time. I had lost my father, and I lost 3 children, and I thought to myself, surely that's enough. But then my wife was not well. We fought the cancer for 3 years. The only thing that I had to hold on to in this time was worship. I'd go grab my guitar and I'd begin to play songs that were very near and dear and familiar to me, or I would write songs. People thought I was crazy, because how do you worship in a time like this? How do you sing a praise song when you're grieving? And how do you give thanks to God when you've lost so much? I mean, even those closest to me, they thought I was nuts. When I was standing by Ezekiel's grave, I was so angry with God. I was like, "Are you kidding me?" And yet I knew that I was angry at a good father. I knew that He understood my pain. I knew that He held me up. And I knew that I wasn't alone. And I remember the Lord spoke to me again in my heart at that point in time, and He said, "I'm going to give you a pound of joy for every ounce of sorrow." These days, I travel around to churches, telling my story, leading people in worship, and reminding them that no matter where you are and no matter what you're going through, God is in control. And your story isn't over. Well, my name is Terry Posthumus. I am the father of 11 children. I've got quite a story to tell you.